For 12 years, Osaka has seen the start of NJPW's summer. Championships have been won and lost, personal feuds have raged, and classic battles have been waged as New Japan Pro Wrestling's very best seek dominion over the world of professional wrestling. As we get set for summer 2021's first major event, let's look at the factors behind dominion. June 20th, 2009 saw the beginning of the Dominion tradition, which arose out of a turbulent period in New Japan Pro Wrestling. Mere weeks before, Togi Makabe was at the forefront of the most powerful and feared faction within NJPW in Great Bash Heel, only to have the rug pulled out from underneath him by Shinsuke Nakamura and Tora Yano. Soon, almost all of GBH had jumped ship to the new group that was Chaos. And the mastermind Yano would strike a blow for the new group with a big win over his former partner on the first ever Dominion. Another shock occurring weeks before that Osaka card was an upset IWGP Heavyweight Championship win for Manabe Nakanishi. The veteran Nakanishi finally secured the title in Korakuen Hall in a title fight arranged at short notice amid a wave of card changes. Nobody was more shocked at that turn of events than former champion Hiroshi Tanahashi, who fought to regain the gold and did so with a high fly flow after over 30 minutes of action in the first Dominion main event. In the coming years, as the balance of power shifted in NJPW, Tanahashi was a stable and consistent presence in the early days of Dominion. The ace would be in the top two matches of every Dominion card for the first 6 years of the event, and was undefeated for the first four. Yet just as his 2021 NEVER Openweight Championship reign was ended by Bullet Club's Jay White at Dontaku, Bullet Club would hand Tanahashi his first Dominion defeat in 2013. After enlisting Bad Luck Fale, Tama Tonga and Carl Anderson to form the group 1 month prior at Dontaku, Prince Devitt and Bullet Club enjoined a reign of terror through the early summer. Winning Best of the Super Junior with a perfect record, Devitt then moved to face Tanahashi, and thanks to a distraction from Fale, scored a victory that would see the junior heavyweight champion to an IWGP Heavyweight Championship challenge and a G1 Climax entry in future months. A year later, Bullet Club would gain even more power, this time Fale taking a lead rather than supporting role, pinning Shinsuke Nakamura in the main event of Dominion 2014 to lift the IWGP Intercontinental Championship. Fale was joined post-match by IWGP Heavyweight Champion AJ Styles and Tag Champions Doc Gallows and Carl Anderson center ring. Bullet Club arguably at the very peak of their championship powers.
We are the Bullet Club, and it's real!
新日本のリングを席巻しているのはバレットクラブです。 IWGP インターコンチ、そしてタッグと、今ベルトはバレットクラブのもとにあります。
1 year on though, and in 2015, AJ Styles' connection to the IWGP Heavyweight Championship was severed, and Japan, entering into the rainy season of June, became most closely associated with the Rainmaker himself. While Kazuchika Okada's 2012 Dominion debut saw his first IWGP Heavyweight Championship reign end at the hands of Tanahashi, he has since gone on to headline the early summer spectacular more than any other wrestler, including as it moved to a grand new stage. Dominion 2015 saw NJPW return to Osaka Joe Hall for the first time since the 1990s, and the event has been in the shadows of the Osaka Castle ever since. With a win over Styles in 2015, Okada began a third IWGP Heavyweight Championship reign that saw most standing in the shadow of the Rainmaker.
世界の新日本プロレスに、いや、プロレス界に、金の雨が降るぞ！
今、
世界がここにあります！
Okada would have a vice-like grip over the IWGP Heavyweight Championship for the next 3 years, the period between Dominion 2015 and Dominion 2018 only seeing one other reign, a brief one at the hands of Tetsuya Naito. Naito's transformation at the head of Los Ingobernables de Japón was inextricably linked to the Dominion host city of Osaka. When Naito was only doing what he believed was right by the fans,Osaka crowds greeted him with derisory boos, but when Naito became ungovernable, he wouldn't let what the fans thought trouble him anymore. With the aid of Sanada, Naito captured the IWGP Heavyweight Championship from Okada in April of 2016 in Ryogoku, but his anti-heroic antics and disrespect to his freshly won title was something the former champion couldn't forgive. At Dominion 2016, Okada took the title back,and wouldn't let it go for a further 720 days.
Okada Kazuchika が時代を取り戻した。時代の中心にまたこの男が戻ってきました。彼の雨を降らせ続けるチャンピオン、Okada Kazuchika。
But though Okada was at the top of the billing in Dominion, it wasn't always as a victor. In 2017, his second match with the brash, egotistical new Bullet Club leader Kenny Omega went the full 60-minute distance before ending in a draw. A classic bout that had the world talking saw the Rainmaker leave with his title thanks to the draw, but with unfinished business still brewing. 1 year later, and having logged the most successful defenses of the IWGP Heavyweight title in history. Okada wanted to tie up loose ends with Omega, and that led to a 2 out of 3 falls bout at Dominion 2018. The longest match in IWGP Heavyweight Championship history would ultimately culminate in an Omega title win.By 2019, Okada was reunited with his championship and back on the Dominion winning track against Chris Jericho. But a post-match attack would certainly leave him in less than perfect form.Then, in 2020, another shocker in Osaka involving Bullet Club left Okada out of the Dominion picture entirely. After a lengthy absence from live events, Dominion 2020 and the New Japan Cup final before it saw crowds return to NJPW at Osaka Joe Hall. Okada had announced his intention to keep up his strong track record of Dominion main events, but instead would be felled by Evil, who joined Bullet Club.And defeated IWGP Heavyweight and Intercontinental Champion Tetsuya Naito the very next night.
Naito,
てしまった。
Those shocking actions made Evil the most talked about figure in NJPW through the summer of 2020. Indeed, with the summer months being a key turning point for the year at large, Dominion has long seen NJPW's best position themselves as high up as possible in the ongoing struggle for power. Nowhere was this more evident than in 2019, when Shingo Takagi, John Moxley, and Kenta.
The G1.
G1!
G1 でお会いしましょう。
Each made their own marks, and each declared entry into that year's G1 climax. As in 2020, this year's Dominion will lead not into the G1, but rather to summer struggle. And never has a series name been more apt. Plenty of question marks will be swirling heading into Dominion, including around the IWGP World Heavyweight Championship vacated due to injury by Will Ospreay. Yet one more tradition that has surrounded Dominion and is sure to continue this year is of great matches and unforgettable action. From Tanahashi and Nakanishi in 2009, through Omega and Okada in 2017 and 2018, to Kota Ibushi and Tetsuya Naito's incredible 2019 war, and Shingo Takagi and Sho in hard-hitting openweight competition in 2020. Who will etch their names in Osaka Joe Hall history in 2021 and create more Dominion legends? Find out June 7th when Dominion comes to you live and in English on the king of sports streaming services, njpwworld.com.